75th anniversary. What a great thing to help celebrate. So we have prepared a group of hymns, folk songs, and spirituals for you, and with a little interlude with one of your favorite people from the church, Mary Beth Ions. So we have a whole variety of things. We're going to start with Ubi Caritas, which is based on a Gregorian chant. It's way back. Where there is love, there is God, is the text. And a mighty fortress. And we end this first section with a contemporary gospel song. So just sit back and enjoy hymns, folk songs, and spirituals.
Thank you. fishermen for James and John. They came with me and the nets went on.
Whoa!
something completely different. We're going to do, it's a gospel hymn called He Never Failed Me Yet. And so we have a little substitution here. Originally scheduled to sing the solo was Colleen Kane and Eric Richardson. Eric is going to sing the solo. Colleen has half a voice today, so Colleen recruited her daughter to sing. So daughter from Kent State School of Music is here, Abbey Kane, and is going to do the solo. So thank you very much, Abby, for stepping in. And here we go with He Never Failed Me.
Thank you.
American folk song, and then a folk song from Japan, sung by the women. And that song is about a little firefly buzzing around. That's all you need to know. And then Down in the Valley by the men, and then a song I think you'll recognize.
Goodbye, gals, I'm going to Boston. Goodbye, gals, I'm going to Boston. Goodbye, gals, I'm going to Boston. Early in the morning. Won't be the pretty in the ballroom. Won't be the pretty in the ballroom. Won't be the pretty in the ballroom. Early in the morning.
Saddle up, gals, I'm
kind of raucous. Wait till you hear this one. An old Southern folk song, boil them cabbage down, bile them cabbage down. We're going to try and recreate that for you. They'll settle there.
Right before this.
Yeah, some rosin on that.
And I'm going to by Tom, who's the wonderful music director here at St. Nell. And yes, Tom. So enjoy the Ashokan farewell from the Civil War.
Thank you.
They go very fast. They go by very quickly. There's actually six movements. These are by the composer Béla Bartók. Have many of you heard of Bartók's music? It was considered very avant-garde for its time. Bartók was born in 1881 in Romania, and he died in 1945 in a New York hospital. He was amazing. He was really pushing the envelope for his era. And a lot of the music he just heard in his head and didn't even write key signatures or anything. He would just write the music down as he heard it in his head. And he became a very famous ethnomusicologist because he loved the music of his land, Romania, but also the bordering countries, Germany, Hungary, all these, you know, even Croatia, Serbia, all these, the former Yugoslavia, he was just entranced with the music of these countries. So he heard, what you're going to hear right now is what Bartók heard on the border between, well, it was actually very appropriate for this time of year. He heard this music in Transylvania. The country of Dracula. And he heard two gypsy violinists playing this music. And it stuck in his head, these tunes. Now the first one is called the stick dance. Maria, you're Romanian. Can you do a stick dance for me? Can she ever play that piano? The second movement is the sash dance, like a sash that you wear around your waist. The third movement is called Pelok, which means in one spot, but it's anything but in one spot, all over the place. That's an interesting one I want to show you. That Bartók uses this technique on the violin we call artificial harmonics. We have regular harmonics. That's where the string divides naturally in half. And other places, sounds like a little whistle, like a flute. Well, Bartók uses these harmonics called artificial harmonics. We have to produce them, and it sounds like a little flute. And that's exactly what he wants. And it sounds Middle Eastern, doesn't it? He was heavily influenced by that. And then we have a gorgeous, gorgeous melody, which really recalls, again, the Middle Eastern tonality of this area. They were using these pentatonic scales, which have five notes. It's like... very Middle Eastern sound. So you'll hear that in a slow movement. And then there's two very quick dances at the end that you have to kind of fasten your seatbelts, so do I, because they're very fast and they're very, very lively, very indicative of what you would see with costumes swirling and all this good stuff. So we start with the stick dance, the sash dance, Pelok, the slow, beautiful movement, two crazy dances, oh, and a polka. There's a polka. Movement number five is a polka. Is that the first time a polka is played in this church?
Beth went to St. Mel's School, so you can be very proud of her. And, you know, Mary Beth is like, you know, there's these icons in Cleveland, like the Terminal Tower and the West Side Market. Mary Beth is the musical icon of Cleveland, Ohio. Everyone knows her. Great association for more than 30 years, and I want to thank Maria too for all her work. High spirituals.
Here we go.
There's a great camp meeting.
There's a great camp.
There's a great camp meeting in the promised land.
thank you so much for having us. The last piece is an arrangement of Zico Sabo.